What did I say to piss you off this time? Baby!
Who is the Negro in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, I say, who is the Negro in your neighborhood when you're running from his ass each day?
Black people don't hope, we wish.
Something that crazy could only come from you.
Right now you live in beliefs. You want to believe things. Belief is ignorance. Right knowledge is to know. Understand that? Belief is ignorance because belief is the acceptance of things that you do not know. And every one of your prayers end with Amen.
Let me hear you say amen. Oh, let me hear you say amen.
Amen, which is the ancient Egyptian god, Amun, and the rock. The rock was the sun in us as the original people of the sun. And we roamed the earth millions of years, 17 million, 20, 50,000 years back, before Adam was created 49,000 years ago. Now, we don't know good people from bad. We don't know good food from bad. We don't know good music from bad. We don't know anything, and we were the ones who knew everything. And so they put us under a spell. What kind of spell? The spell of ghost worship. You understand? Ghost worship. And they said gospel. Ghost spell. All you know is what they told you, and you have belief in what they told you. When we were in our right state, state of Elohim, we didn't have beliefs. We knew, because we were the gods that everybody worshiped. They made us taste the rising of the sun. By telling us, make sure you don't make fudge while the sun is rising. That's because we were sun people. People trying to get away from the sun made us start hating the sun. How'd they make you hate your hair? No, by telling you to pick cotton. The moment we start comping our hair and cussing our hair and putting our feet on the grass again, things are going to start opening. We lost our eye and our light is dim.
Right from New York to Jamaica to Cali to Japan to Algeria to Paris to Norway to Belgium to Africa to Egypt to Domo Mercy Be Cool. Live from Ground Zero. Oh, shit. I'm fucking all this shit up. I don't give a fuck. Yeah. It's your fast 30 minutes on air. Your radio show. Bust that ass radio at 83.17 FMX. And it stands for you never saw me coming because you never saw what was that, dumbass. The black lady who's on the loose who's better than that bald and mini be two pump chump of a boyfriend. And yes, I'll run rings around that flat ass like something. So test me, bitch. And if I say anything to offend you, do you know I'm doing my motherfucking job? Because you have the option of turning me off when I keep turning you on again and again and again. Ah. Like the ghetto burning my motherfucking drawers because I didn't pay the goddamn bill for the fucking had them shit fucking dry clean right this week. Fuck. Oh, well. Anyway. Oh, yes. Here we go at the top of the show. That's right. Cash ass, bitches. Let's ride. Alrighty. So. L.A. Racing Entitlement Man, as we start to tell like that. Okay, so we started with the question of the day. And it goes a little something like this. It's the late show. Does the end of art and music programs in L.A. mean so much to the status quo has to keep a silent lid on scholastics that are not as judgmental to the current courses taught to students at the bequest of creational sterility, or does co-interpol stand to separate freedom of expression from groups of people only to mass assemble the current mistakes made in vanity to a failing record label structure? You be the judge. Okay, hey, this is part three, man, so come on now. Today in Black History Month, we learn to deal with the sounds of black freedom. Now more so than ever, when individuality is easier to control and ruin at the sake of fame and the chasing of dead presidents. No, African Bambaataa will not get the Nobel Peace Prize for a legacy of peace and music because it goes against the mode of the Jewish-owned label system we call the RIAA. Get a clue on this, all right? Check it. How many current black bands do you know of besides Fishbone? You can't name one now, can you, you pop dick sucker? Our music was often called race music by white Americans to highlight the fact that as a people, the African experience is unique and our expressions culturally rich. The focus of various summit meetings was on calling attention to the historically corrupt, exploited, and one-sided business dealings perpetuated by the music industry. The focus was on what particular strategies can be implemented to end the injustice. According to FBI documents, one of the purposes of the COINTELPRO program was to expose, disrupt, misdirect, discredit, or otherwise neutralize the activities of black nationalists. They wanted to prevent the rise of a black messiah, and Martin Luther King Jr. had been among the candidates until his assassination in 1968, when the attention shifted to Huey P. Newton. Of the 295 documented actions taken by COINTERPOL to disrupt black groups, 233 were directed against the Black Panther Party. Even your sly petty Michael Jackson took on Sony Music chairman Tommy Mottola, accusing the head of his record company of being a racist and part of a racist conspiracy against black artists. Most of Jackson's comments were constrained to the overall treatment of black artists, the struggle of whom he shared with. The King of Pop compared his troubles with his record company to those artists who struggled financially, saying that they were incredible. They went through incredible injustice altogether, and that shit was taking place. Have you guys been, like, you know, listening to any of the commercials lately at all? Okay. Big Papa sounded pretty fucked up with the dude carrying a baby. Okay. Damn. My nigga Biggie is dead, and his family never sees a dime out of that shit. Okay? And from on the Isley Brothers loop on that shit, the Isley Brothers never got paid any fucking way. You know where I'm going with this, right? What the fuck? Okay? Shit's real, though. MJ said the recording companies really, really do conspire against the artists. They steal, they cheat, they do everything they can, especially against black artists. People from James Brown to Sammy Davis Jr., some of the real pioneers that inspired him to be an entertainer, these artists, dead or alive, you know, are always on tour, because if they don't stop touring, they'll starve to fucking death. I mean, if you fight for them, you're fighting for all black people, dead or alive, all right? And bitches like Lars from Metallica is screaming that he's being raped of his music from illegal downloading. Dude, nobody questioned Lars on how the music got online in the first place. I mean, what label money? What? I mean, come on, dude. What? I mean, label money dick in your mouth? Need some cheddar cheese with that? Guess he can wait on his deathbed then. I mean, Prince did the same thing to Warner Brothers by publicly denouncing them and buying back his contract. Back then, it was called buying your freedom from the master before you got sold to someone else. Ain't much different in the Matrix now, is it? Shit happens in basketball all day. Lots of separation anxiety. Motherfuckers is moved like chess pieces, or does the money blind the performance so motherfuckers don't know the half? I mean, shit, man. Maybe in the average white band. Think about it. I'll be black after this.
Shoot them in their motherfucking face.
Facebook report, Fabi Genetic! Ah, the stuff I found on my Facebook is amazing, shocking, but true. This infamous ass buster, Noel Mooney, you are such drunk driving on my laughter today. I mean, she's great. Shocking page post revelation. It says, with a woman awash in her sorrow, 19 kids and counting, sisters, wives, toddlers and tiaras, and Honey Boo Boo are all on the Learning Channel. What are we learning about America's white trash problem? Not a damn thing, except they act as bad as we do on the camera. This one in from Ashbuster OG Husky Radio. A big post of completion. Sylvester. Don't slow. Sylvester, the cat. Finally eats Tweety and has blood all over the place. Damn right, motherfucker's been trying since 1942. You think you'd be vegan, but, you know, it only proves that whatever your dream is, kill it before it kills you. And finally, from Ashbuster Jaguana, loving to be always Mason, my super niece from the East. A big post of why so many dog-ass niggas cry at text time. It says, it's fucked up. It says, with the brother in painful tears, the reaction when he finds out child support is garnishing his income tax check. Oh, I know, Mr. Boston really looks forward to this with all his baby mamas. And that's plural. Drama llama ding dong, fuck you Donkey Kong. I'm rich, bitch!
Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. Marketed to Earth as an entrance from the distant planet Krypton exploded. And who, disguised as Clark Kent, mild-mannered reporter for the Daily Planet, fights a never-ending battle for truth, justice, and freedom with superpowers far beyond those ordinary mortals.
It's Superman, 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 Superman.
Oh my God, Black Abarca, and the message is coming through. The best kind of justice is the justice you get when you're buried in the ground, dirt napping. No, really. I got blindsided by a seagull ship running around the lake this morning, but it's metaphysical of how justice is meted out, and those that do for the sake of purification ought to consider the steps necessary for a patada en el culo. Check it. Y'all know the song Lee and Molly by Ziggy Marley. I'm pretty sure you do. Well, he should have sung about something a little bit more historic in a mistrial. Okay, there was a mistrial of the 9 Scottsboro Boys of Alabama. This is where race and sex intersegregated in the segregated South. Precisely on March 25th, 1931. Lots of good fucking going on here. It was then a sheriff's posse stopped a train at Pain Rock. 9 black youths ages 12 to 19 were hoboing on the train and thought they were being arrested for fighting whites on the train. Instead, they were accused of gang raping 2 women, white women, who were also riding the freight train. See, Ann Coulter was right. That's later in the show. The 9 from Georgia and Tennessee went on trial in Scottsboro and were convicted by an all-white jury. All but the youngest received a death sentence, but later won new trials. One of the women recanted her story. 5 of the Scottsboro boys eventually had the rape charges dropped, while 4 were convicted during their retrial. So whatever happened to the other lying bitch? She must have moved to Arizona by now. The whole state's racist anywho, so, you know, there you have it. They have no fucking chocolate ice cream out there anyway. But here's the kicker. It's an 83-year-old case that's actually considered the birth of the civil rights movement. This produced 2 significant U.S. Supreme Court decisions saying that criminal defendants are entitled to effective counsel and that blacks can't be systematically excluded from criminal juries. And get this, it brings in the bucks. I mean, what the fuck? State Tourism Director Lee Sentinel said civil rights tourism has become an important part of the state's travel business, and the Scottsboro Boys Museum is among the attractions promoted by the state. Wow. So there's a hotel tour. Well, MLK got shot, there's a driver's tour where JFK got shot, and maybe a new high school where Robert F. Kennedy got shot. Keep in mind, folks, they got murdered by the government, which is a bigger difference than when the state sanctioned the murder of poor blacks as a practice to profile it. It's a good thing, too. Strom Thurmond would have been shot for mixing it up, you think? But when you're the exception to the rule, foul motherfuckers is foul. Just look at the current system of railroading niggas and ask. Are criminal defendants always provided with effective assistance of counsel? If so, our juries have been chosen free of racial discrimination. For that answer, stop playing Xbox and see how bored a motherfucker get. Shit. Bitch better have my motherfucking way.
Got up this morning, things weren't working right. I said I wanna make a change, I said I wanna fight. Obama walked up and said, yes, we can. I said I wanna ride your nuts, cause I think you're the man. Now I'm dick riding Obama, Obama. Now I'm dick riding.
Tomorrow, dick riding for today, dick riding for the straight, dick riding for the gay, dick riding for America, dick riding for Iraq. It's okay to ride that dick, just as long as it's Barack's. And now we're
dick riding, motherfucker, on some dirty condoms. Told y'all it was a late show, so fuck it. Block is hot. Besides the usual rundown on hapless hoes, police came knocking on the door today looking for a nigga who jumped parole. Yeah, and I knew this kid when he was like 5 years old. His mama was on the verge of insanity when she moved out of the building with a thin crackhead, Charlie. Another baby later, Aki's been to prison and he's a wanted man. He's on the run, fugitive, nigga, run. Hey, I tried to intervene, but bitch was mad at me for housing a hoe with three kids of her own, who have since been deported to foster care. And you wonder why I'm not married to a screwball bitch. Look at what they're doing outside of Logic and tell me how in the fuck is I'm supposed to work for pussy nepotism. The kid's a fucking runner, and it'll be safe to say he's out of state by now. That's pretty much all that where he's probably gone. Police told me to keep a vigilant eye out for him. Like he's mine. Oh, yeah. You know, take care of your brother. That shit, you know, be your brother's keeper and everything. The fuck? I ain't that damn stupid. Cultural nepotism. Ah, oh, my goodness. Parents who say their kids are out of control have yet to beat the spoiled ass with a hot comb and butter. Then again, treat them like they think they're supposed to be treated since they want to grow up so goddamn bad. Shit, bitches. Wait till finding a job becomes a job. Check it. Penelope Soto, 17, learned the hard way that when you talk back to a judge, things could go quickly downhill. I mean, this shit was viral. I mean, after being arrested for drug possession in Miami, Soto appeared before Judge Jorge Rodriguez Stromat, only to giggle, play with her hair, and roll her eyes at him. Ding! It may have been an attempt to disarm the judge with girly cuteness, but failed miserably. And after an initial bond set at $5,000, Soto gave a caddy adios and walked away, only to be called back and have her bond upped to $10,000 for contempt. Ding, ding! Astounding! Soto asked if he was serious, and when he replied he was, she gave him an angry bird and told him to go fuck himself. The punishment for her attitude, 30 days in jail. Ding, 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 ding. Oh, robo-dope like a motherfucker, we got a winner. Give Miss Dipshit a corncob pipe and some whiskey, because she'll be the first hoe graduating from high school with a jail record. Not like that's the norm, but somebody needs to explain to these stupid bitches you gotta be cook, clean, fuck, certified before you flip off the law. That's code, bitch. What the fuck? This one's got hoe in training written all over it. Bernie Mac was right. Beat them till the meat fall out their heads. Cute love only goes but so far, baby, and the self-entitlement act of, oh, I'm special, comes about erringly with nothing more than a con game. That's all this shit is. What this stupid puta failed to see is that in court, the judge pretty much rules Babylon. My question is this: if the parents knew their kid then, why in the hell wasn't there a civilized intervention? I mean, bitch be sneaking out at odd hours of the night to hang with her friends because the dad bitch is a night owl, smoking weed and getting high and fucking God, one knows, whatever. Now that Miss Imperial dumbass has lost 30 days of her freedom, she'll do what most little cave bitches will do. Sit there and stew in her decision she made, as TLC will consider giving her a reality TV show for her viral video. Hey, they canceled All My Baby's Mama, so the time slot couldn't be better. I would call the show. Okay, and seriously, I would fucking call the show 1% Ho with a Problem.
A rat done bit my sister Nell with Whitey on the moon. Her face and arms began to swell and Whitey's on the moon. I can't pay no doctor bills, but Whitey's on the moon. 10 years from now, I'll be paying still while Whitey's on the moon. You know, the man just upped my rent last night, cause Whitey's on the moon. No hot water, no toilets, no lights, but Whitey's on the moon. I wonder why he's upping me, cause Whitey's on the moon. Well, I was already giving him 50 a week, and now Whitey's on the moon. Taxi's taking my whole damn check. The junkies make me a nervous wreck. The price of food is going up. And as if all that crap wasn't enough, a rat done bit my sister Nell with Whitey on the moon. Her face and arms began to swell and Whitey's on the moon. With all that money I made last year for Whitey on the moon, how come I ain't got no money here? Whitey's on the moon. You know, I just about had my fill of Whitey on the moon. I think I'll send these doctor bills, air mail special. To Whitey on the moon.
You can take niggas out of the country, but you can't take the country out of niggas. Niggas are lovers, are lovers, are lovers. Niggas love to hear Malcolm rap, but they didn't love Malcolm. Niggas love everything but themselves. But I'm a lover too. Yep, I'm a lover too. I love niggas, I love niggas, I love niggas. Because niggas are me, and I should only love that which is me. I love to see niggas go to jail.
Ah, I guess we've now come to the butt end of the show, and the only way to put a perspective on that gives you a gas face, you gotta take both your thumbs and pry open that vertical mouthpiece and look that brown eye straight in the eye and pull the trigger on that person, place a thing that's causing the madness and strife in your life. On the 1, 2, 3, the mighty Moose, just breathe in and stab it in the cabin as we count it. Y'all know how we do this. And a 1, and a 2, and a 3, and a mighty woosah, asshole of the day. 2013 and 5 days into the Black Mystery Month. Could there be any reason why some people, as affluent as they think they are, still don't trust nobody black in their hyphenated circle of racist liberality? Then again, women who pick up the habits of the men they admire are subject to random shifts of stupidity. So much for the fuzzy logic. Hello, Kitty. Check it. Meet Ann Coulter, the satanic afterbirth of Rush Limbaugh. She's a walking frontal lobotomy, that's for sure. Anyways, brain baggage. Bitch refused to stay on board a Miami to New York commercial airline flight today after learning the pilot was a woman of African American descent. According to witnesses' reports, Coulter was concerned the experienced decorated pilot in question may have gained her position as a result of affirmative action and was fully qualified to fly, stating, "Oh, come on, people, a black woman flying a plane? You know, she's got that job through affirmative action." Am I the only one worried about this? I mean, hello? Our lives are at stake here. I mean, what's next? Are we going to let Mexicans become doctors now? Jesus Christ, people. Realizing her efforts to provoke a mutiny had come to naught, Bum Bitch then took her carry-on bags and bolted back up the jetway towards the gate against the orders of the flight attendants, which is a federal offense. But we all know how it goes down, right? Crazy crack bitch goes nuts. And she never sees jail time whatso fucking ever. What the fuck? Clearly this woman has some sort of mental illness, explains TSA spokesperson Dirk Diggler. Let me read that again. TSA spokesperson Dirk Diggler. We recommended it against pressing charges and mandated a full psychiatric evaluation. The pilot in question was trained by the U.S. Air Force and was decorated veteran for the wars of Iraq and Afghanistan, where she flew aerial refueling missions for transport and reconnaissance aircraft. She has been flying for American Airlines for 4 years and is one of the airline's most experienced 737 pilots. Damn shame, ain't it? Motherfucker can get an Oscar for driving Miss Daisy for flying Miss Malcontent a whole bowl of fried shit now, ain't it? Fact of the matter is this, Madam Bimbo Bum Bitch is what's known in the free world as a catalyst for pagan anarchy of a dying breed of assholes. Namely the ones still salted by Lord Obama's return to the phone. Kind of reminds me of when I was flying out to Georgia and I made this white woman nervous while sitting next to her. Shit was funny, yo. I was reading Jim Goad's Redneck Bible, and I guess when she saw what I was reading, bitch got agitated. Shit, Jim Goad's a white author who scares the shit out of white people with non-conservative values on class and race. To quote simply from page 109, if the poor in the state should black, white, brown, yellow, whatever, marched on Washington, D.C., the government would be at a coup. Meaning, poor people do have the overall right, 101, when it comes to revolution. As long as politics and money divide, you know, and conquer, we ain't getting shit. That's what Little Orphan Annie's all about. But she's rather hide it instead of divide it. Pussy must be funky because the hoe needs dick maybe more than twice every 7 years. Yep. And clusterfuck culture, you are the saddest bum bitch asshole of the day.
He will be here forever. Do you understand? Forever. Forever and ever and ever and ever. We will be here forever. Do you understand that? Get what I'm saying? Forever.
This is hip hop. Manifesting as the Blast Master KRS-One.
Take a slug for the cause like UEP. While all you fake niggas try to copy Master P.
Evolutionary, what? Revolutionary, you're legendary.
Smack them cheese while you stream your majesty.
You ain't fucking with the teacher, let me sum this up. Every time I come around, you demo niggas is running up. And I don't mind until I hear KRS is what? Then I say to myself, this cat is dumb as fuck. Or maybe he's just mad, cause he's young and he's stuck. Stuck in the hood, good, cause my guns is up. When I blast you, it ain't gonna make no sense. I'ma tell the judge, Your Honor, it was self-defense. I'm KRS-One, this guy's a thief. The threat was in his mouth, so I shot out his teeth. You ain't funny, I'll track you like pottery, man. You not a rapper, you a reject from Def Comedy Jam. You don't really wanna try this, kid? I'm positive, I'm a plus, you negative. You what a minus is. I get painfully in your face like sinuses. Your watch is rocked up, but you still don't know what time it is.
Highest in the sickest individual in the residence. Together with the gods of rap, only after that president. And represent for my people, the starving and ignored. Trapped within a country that we've all been targeting for war. So they martyr for reward and the afterlife. And hopes of the people that left behind never have to have that fight. Raging hash for life, expanding my horizons. We monumental like the rise of tigers. All the new men are taking my decide and empty the phone.
That's right, if you miss it, then play it again. So you get it, you can say move forward like a bitch, but you know I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been in your own radio show shows. Bust that ass radio, 83.17 FM. Any extent, so you never send me comments, because you never saw what's at all up in your ass. Say it's like in the room, boom, harder than ever, booty bubbles and booty calm. New music provided by Omega 7 Records, the mother chick connection, and the biggest underground music scene ever. Check us out on much777.wix.com/bust-that-space-ass-radio. That's right, people. That's right, these are stinky on a blog, dirty condoms, 104,000 motherfuckers on the planet, like my shit. And we'll also link to Jaws 1UP Networks at much77.wix.com/omega7om7, the only community arts and entertainment non-profit in the world. So get LinkedIn, cause it's all about cash your ass and seeing the street, bitches. I rip
points, hollows, how many niggas will follow? Get caught up in the wrong alley, blast your monkey ass to Cali. Strap twist a nigga for no money. The thugs that I run with is gunsmiths, most of them drug mummies. Jerry flashing, brick Aston, 10 of the same color. Car hard jumpers in love, but you know we pop for this money, don't play with us. If you want protection, sign here and stay with us. I'm just a messenger, a nigga with blessings, sir. Sponsored by some strong good boy niggas, hammers on hecklers.
Culmination of conquering nations, the intersection of revolution and revelations, the inspiration Galileo gave to astrologers, testament to the gods, like the central part obelisk. I will flat the impaler you on Cleopatra's needle, conjuring the spirit of the devil that lives inside of people. Evil is temptation, always surrounds the righteous and doesn't spare an expense, cause corruption is priceless. Medieval torture devices in a cathedral basement, upgraded to Guantanamo Bay's replacement. You're ignorant. hatreds, fertilizes the earth's hatreds. Give it up before you die, like the Autobot Matrix. You think nobody's a house nigga, nobody's racist. The man's vagina's bleeding, nobody's the rapist. Open your eyes, you faceless. Blog is fear and habit, and break the system and live outside of the risk.